Well, I had the opportunity to visit all of our schools this year, and it's been a wonderful experience to share in faith and hope and love with all of our students and faculty and staff. And of course, there's always one really good question. So last year, the question was from the Super Pixie, do you dye your hair? And of course, I told everyone, no, but you see what you get ironed this time. This year, the question was from another Super Woman, are you God?
Companionship. And that's where we start.
It's being in conversation with the Lord Jesus, and it's being in that special communion with Him, and knowing Him, and coming to hear Him speaking in our lives, and letting Him speak to us, letting Him touch our lives through what we do. We as priests, especially in the sacraments of the church, in those moments when we preach and teach, those are really amazing. But for all faithful, it is the moments of prayer and the call to enter into the Word of God and to let the Word of God truly touch our lives. One little thing we do with the super little ones in the school is we usually have songs that we sing with them because the attention span is pretty fast. I say that with all humor. Sometimes our attention span is pretty fast too. And the song that gets sung over and over again is "This Little Light of Mine." This little light of mine. And you know, in many ways, that simple song speaks these scriptures to us. That simple song. Because in the end, it is the light of Christ that we share. And it's the light of Christ that is given to us. It's the light of Christ that enters into that conversation, that companionship moment that we have with the Lord. The other thing St. John Paul II had written was about communion, namely of confession. And to let the Lord truly touch our lives in that way. First, confession in terms of belief, that I believe that Jesus lived, suffered, died, and rose from the dead, and to let that really be spoken through everything we do and say and who we are. And then second, it'd be a confession of reconciliation. And we are really called to be men of reconciliation. When we sit in the reconciliation room, the confessional, if you will, those are moments of really allowing God to work through us, to bring healing and peace to our people. And to our faithful and to all the other people, where else can you receive forgiveness? They don't have it at Walmart, trust me. I checked, it's not going to be us. To let the love of Christ truly touch us. And the third is communion of really sanctification and teaching. Both. And in that way, you know, the Lord Jesus truly calls us to come to know Him as Messiah, as our Lord and Savior, and to allow the Jubilee year, if you will, of forgiveness and healing to be a part of our lives too, and to truly touch us and bless us. It's part of the reason we're going to bless the holy oils during this Mass. And the powerful memory of having families at Saturday night receiving the oil of catechumens first, and tears literally come into their eyes that they are touched by the healing power of Christ. And the anointing chrism for those young people who have received the sacrament of confirmation, the Spirit of God coming upon them, the Spirit of God touching us. And then the oil of the sick. What a wonderful moment for each of us as priests to be touched and be touched by the risen Lord Jesus in the anointing of the sick. It's a wild moment for each of us. And it's a moment that happens really over and over again for us. That's part of our call. That's part of who we are called to be. So let's pray during this Eucharist that this may be a jubilee Mass for us, that as we renew our promises as priests, we may say before the Lord Jesus, "I love you." And we may hear Him say to us, "I love you. I love you." the faithful as you witness the vows being renewed and promises, it's a time for you also to renew your baptism promises. When the Lord has called you to be his witnesses and his grace. The Spirit of the Lord is the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to captives, release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord. That's today.